Hi, this is Fran with Little Windows, and here's a great how-to for working with resin in open back bezels. One thing that makes this easy is the No-Residue Resin Backer Film from LittleWindows.com. You can use this with both epoxy and UV resin. Each package has 12 large sheets of film. These are nice and stiff, which makes them easy to work with. Each has a clear, shiny, protective backer. I like using these more than packing tape because they're stiff and they won't leave any wrinkles in your resin project. They're super shiny and won't dull your resin surface, and they don't leave any residue. As long as they're clean, they're reusable. So here's an example of an open back bezel. This one happens to be made out of shell and it's got holes drilled through so that you can turn it into jewelry. I have three different kinds of bezels here. Make sure they're stuck well. For the simple metal frame, I'll be adding embossed Dichro-ISH films. These are left over from our embossing video. Be sure to check that one out too. Push the film down against the bezel and it will form a ring. This is your guide for cutting. So I was able to cut all three layers at once. Make sure they fit in your bezel before you start. I'm using Brilliant Resin. This is the safest epoxy you'll find, and I'm working in very small batches. Even so, make sure you have good ventilation in your space. If you have chemical sensitivities, if you're mixing larger batches, making larger projects, or using resin a lot, make sure to protect yourself with a vapor mask or respirator and gloves. I'm going to add a press-dried flower to this bezel. When you're working with open back bezels, it's helpful if you let your resin thicken up a bit for this first layer. This can help prevent any leaks if your surface or your bezel is uneven. I've got my resin mixed up, and I want to pour a layer just above the edge of the bezel. For this middle one, we're going to be sandwiching these Dichro-ISH films, so just pour a thin layer to start. And in this third one, I'll be making a geode. So I'll start with a layer of clear resin here as well. For the geode project, I'm going to use colorants to make black resin and white resin. Once I've used a mixing cup for a certain color, I'll write that color on the outside. This way I don't have to be so careful in terms of cleaning them before mixing again. This colorant is very opaque, so you only need a few drops. It blends really easily without adding bubbles. And makes a nice opaque color. Now I need some black resin. In this cup you'll see there's some left over from a previous project. So I'll roll the cup between my palms to loosen that resin and use my fingers to wipe out all the little bits clinging to the edge. I don't need very much resin. Again, add just a few drops. And look how easily this blends. Glossy, black, beautiful finish with no extra bubbles. If your resin doesn't spread by itself, you may need to help it to the edges. I've got a little bubble in this one. I'll scoop it out with my mixing wand. Now for the first layer of Dichro-ISH film. I'm going to lay that in the base of the bezel and use my mixing wand to gently push it down. I want to make sure there's no large air bubbles trapped underneath. Put another small amount of resin and spread that around. Let's get this bubble out of here. I can either use my mixing wand or a tiny pointy swab. Second layer of Dichro-ISH films. Just place that on top and again use my mixing wand to push it down across the surface. And I can see there's quite a big air pocket there, so I'll work that out with my mixing wand, letting it escape around the side. Third layer of resin. And the last layer of Dichro-ISH film. See that large bubble at the top side? Now that this thing is quite full of resin, it's a little trickier to get that out, but I'm pushing it down and allowing it to escape. Oops, got a little resin overboard. Now I'll pour the last layer on top, doming up my piece for a beautiful rounded shine. Now for the shell piece. I'll just lay this dried flour across the top and let it meet the resin. This flour is porous, so it's going to stick pretty well on its own. And all I need to do is add a dome layer to the top. The resin is quite thick at this point, but it will still level beautifully. Now for the geode effect. I've let the resin with the black and white colorant set up for about a half an hour, so it's nice and thick. This makes it easier for me to control where it goes. This is a bit of a random technique. First, I'm adding stripes of white, and then black to the outside, kind of a random squiggly way. Now I'll use my tiny pointy swabs to move the colors around and create some more interesting designs. These swabs are great because you can wipe them off and reuse them. They've got some absorption, but unlike a Q-tip, they're very firm and they won't leave any fluff in your projects. Now I'll add some pieces of chunky silver glitter. I still have plenty of time to move these. I went a little overboard with that glitter, so I'm going to come back in with my white and black colorant and add a bit more. You can just noodle around with these designs. Once you like the effect you've got, cover it up and let it set for 12 hours, or longer if you'd like. Ooh, I like how these pieces turned out. Now I'm peeling off the film and you can see how shiny that surface is. There's no tape residue left at all, and it's beautifully clear in the center. I put tape on the sides of this bezel before we started. That's because it has holes and I didn't want the resin to run through. I didn't end up pouring very deep anyway, so I was able to slide a headpin through, add a pearl and some beads, and make a necklace. Now let's check out the metal ring with Dichro-ISH Films. This peels off nice and clean too. As you can see, I got a little messy on this one and we had some overflow. This is easy to fix by just peeling it off. The front of this piece is nicely domed and the back is flat. If you want, you can dome that side too, but I like how it looks this way. Nice and shiny with no adhesive residue. Because this piece is translucent, it's going to pick up and react with whatever colors you put it on. Here's how it looks when you put it on a darker cardboard. You get more blue and purple reflections. And on white paper, you'll see much more of the pink and the gold. I added a heart key charm to the front of this piece and turned it into a necklace. Now let's peel the last piece off. Again, smooth and clean. Ooh, I really like this one. It looks like you're peeking through a window. Because this shell was uneven, a bit of the resin leaked underneath. You can either trim that off or dome the backside. Or just leave it. This one has a really nice dome too. You can really see the detail of that flower when we put it in the sun. You can also use resin backer film to make ornaments, coasters, maybe a paperweight. And you can also do flat pour jewelry or bendy resin projects like these. Come to little-windows.com for resin supplies and help with your projects. Please subscribe and click the bell so you're notified when we have new tutorials.